Before we start today's video, I just wanted to do a quick flip through of my July bullet journal spread since not all of you guys follow me on TikTok where I make those videos. I did, however, make a video of me setting up these July bullet journal spreads, so if you're interested in the theme and want to recreate it for yourself or anything like that, or just see how I made it, then go ahead and check out that video. But so starting off, this is the quote and cover page. These words were written in like the adventure book font from the adventure book in Pixar's movie Up. There's some paper airplanes, and then this is just a globe and it says July, and I use the same 8 colors on this cover page throughout the entire month, and you can see there's like a little gray shadow, so that's how I incorporated the gray. Moving on to the calendar, so you can see it's not totally finished out because I'm currently filming this on the 24th, and this video is going up on the 25th, but the calendar just looks like a foldable map. I think it's really cool how it turned out. I also like wrote in a thicker pen than like in the other calendars that I have. Let me find an example. You can see like it's thinner here than it is here, so I think I like this better. I've been using this pen to write in the calendar, if it'll focus. I'll have to do a whole video on these pens because I really love them, but before I had been writing them in like a Micron pen, the 02 one. This one right here. It's not focusing, but oh well. Anyway, I think it's really fun. And then there's like the little travel adventure icons and the 3D letters. And then next, so my habit tracker was the little suitcase thing. Of course, we journaled every day. Vitamin, pretty good, you know. Didn't take it a few days here and there. Making my bed, I also did very good. I haven't updated my today's stuff, but I did make my bed today and I'm gonna be journaling today and whatnot. I'm pretty healthy this month, except for like the little first week here. And then skincare was pretty good as well. And we don't need to talk about exercising. This was definitely my worst month in a very long time. I've just been so busy with everything and I've definitely not been prioritizing it, which is on me. Hopefully next month will be better. Then the mood tracker. This was probably my favorite spread. I think it's so cute how it turned out. Here are all of my different moods, and you'll see later in the video that my August moods are a little different, but you just color in a doodle each day. They're so cute. I think my favorite one honestly might have been the one I did yesterday. My moods and the colors coordinated with it were just like so perfect for like the airplane colors. I thought it was so cute. Mess up on this one. I meant to color the lid yellow. And yeah, overall, pretty fun, pretty cute. Moving on, here's what the sleep tracker is looking like. I got pretty okay sleep overall. There's a lot of like 7 hours here. There's some 8 hours. We got a couple 9+ hours. That's unheard of for me. I love the cute little airplanes flying around. And you know, we only had one day with like less than 4 hours of sleep, so we're doing good. And then lastly, the water tracker. Honestly, I should do a better job of drinking water this coming month because you can see I had a lot of days where I didn't drink a lot of water. We did have some good days, kinda. We only had one day so far that is 8+. I am sad about that, but overall the spread itself looks really cool and I really love how it turned out. And again, if you're interested in these spreads, I did make a video where I made all of them, and they also are up on my Etsy shop. There are blank versions, so like this isn't here on the blank copy, so that you can like use it for any month that you want, and same with this, that's not there, and like things are all blank for you to use for any month. There are also non-colored copies, so you can like color in everything yourself. But anywho, without further ado, let's get on with the August bullet journal spreads. Alrighty, so my August bullet journal spread theme is princess or Disney princess. I think this might be one of my favorite spreads that I've done. I just think it was like pretty creative and just turned out super beautiful. But really quick, I did just want to say I tried making a little background thing for this little setup that we got going on. I just pulled like a bunch of little things from my room, like jewelry and whatnot. That just kind of like reminded me of like the princess vibe. But anyway, so here you can see the like little quote page and the cover page for the princess themed spread. So the quote is, "So this is love, so this is what makes life divine." And I was originally gonna do the like classic Cinderella quote of "a dream is a wish your heart makes," but I felt like that was like super common. Like I feel like it's kind of everyone uses it, although it's a great quote, don't get me wrong, but I just thought that this would be a fun little different thing to do, so I used that Cinderella quote instead, and it just makes me really happy. Anyway, I also added like 3 big giant like star things that you can see, little sparkly guys, and I ended up adding a bunch of little dots and everything just like all around the page, but you'll see that when I add color later on. So the castle itself is supposed to be the Magic Kingdom castle and like, you know, Cinderella's castle and everything. It took so long to sketch out and try and just create. I used a Pinterest picture for reference, but even then it just was so difficult. And then even like outlining it in pen, I just used my little baby like ruler that I had accidentally broken and I just used that throughout like the whole thing. Honestly, I'm very proud of how it turned out. The colors that I chose for it, which you'll see later on in the video, is a little questionable, but you know. And also, if you see my phone popping in on screen at all, that's just me filming like my little TikToks, because I also upload little tutorials on each spread over there. And then I also have a bunch of other TikToks and tutorials and videos and everything that I don't have here on my YouTube channel. So make sure to go check that out if you haven't. Anyway, for the calendar, so I started off just by, of course, outlining everything, but this calendar was supposed to be inspired by Frozen. So each spread that I did has a different, you know, princess kind of theme. And so for the calendar, I just had like these separated squares. So you can see me kind of like, you know, outlining them and everything, but it'll come together here in a second. I added like a shadow of color to each of the squares of the calendar, which you'll see when I add color later on in the video. But I haven't done a calendar like this in my bullet journal, so I thought it was like really fun and just like a different thing to kind of like play around with. And then you can see that like there are a bunch of like extra days as well, and that's just because when I scan in the bullet journal copies, it's so that like anyone can use the spreads for any month, so that like, you know, the days still line up with the monthly layout. I used the same Disney font that I had on the quote and cover page. I actually carried out that font throughout the entirety of all of my August spreads, which I think was just a fun little touch. And then I also used my like smallest Micron pen, it's like the 005 size, to outline all of the little snowflakes and everything all around. And then of course I had to add the numbers of the calendar. I also added the days of the week, also in the Disney font. And then another thing I did, which I did later on, you don't see it on camera I don't think, I added little like snowflake things around the calendar, but you'll see that later on. The next spreads are the habit tracker and the mood tracker. Again, you can see my little sketched out everything. It just makes it go a lot smoother and everything, because there's so much trial and error with these sketches. But so for the habit tracker, this one is inspired by The Princess and the Frog. There are little lily pads for each habit that I am tracking, and I also added a bunch of little fireflies or lightning bugs, whatever you call them. And then I also added the calendars to the insides of the lily pads. Something that I did differently this month is that I just had a big box for the calendars. It's kind of similar to how on the main calendar, it's a whole big, you know, square of everything. And if you look back in my other videos, or even just at like my little July flip through earlier on in this video, you can see that the habit tracker calendars are like specifically shaped to the months. So it might not be like a perfect rectangle or anything. Again, this just makes it easier for like people who buy the bullet journal spreads on my Etsy shop that like are using a blank copy. So you can see here, like as I'm filling out the like days of the month and everything, it doesn't fill up all of the little squares. So I'll just leave those blank whenever I'm like filling out my bullet journal spreads. But again, I just made it easier. And then also you can see the little Disney font up at the top. And same with the mood tracker, use the same Disney font. Super cute, super nice. This spread was inspired by Beauty and the Beast, so it's just a bunch of different little roses and everything. Took me a while to figure out how exactly I wanted to draw the roses, but overall I think that they are super pretty. Technically, they don't look exactly like roses if I'm being honest, but I just think that these flowers are very pretty and I like it a lot. So I just sketched a whole bunch of them. And one thing I do want to mention though is that when you're thinking about coloring flowers and like the colors that you choose for the mood tracker, I was like, I really don't want to end up with a day where I have to like color the leaves red or something. Like, how am I gonna guarantee that I'm always gonna have a day that has at least a green color and a red color or something for the roses? So what I did is I split the moods and everything into productivity levels for the leaves, which are like green and everything, and then pinks and reds for the flowers. But as always, you will see that later on when I get to that portion of the video where I add color. The sleep tracker is honestly probably my favorite spread of all of them. It is inspired by Tangled or Rapunzel, and so it's basically just a bunch of the floating lanterns. And then I also had three of the little like Rapunzel suns all like kind of around it, which I thought was just a fun little touch. And then at the bottom, which you'll see me outlining now, is the little like boat that they were on, or like canoe, whatever it's called. And it's just like a little outline of Flynn Rider and Rapunzel in the little boat. And it's so cute, oh my gosh. And then lastly, the water tracker is inspired by the Little Mermaid. So it's just a bunch of little doodles and like icons of under the sea type things. So there are bubbles, there are little seashells and starfishes. As I'm doing this right here, sketching them all out, you'll see that not all of them have all the details in just yet. That's just because I went in with with a smaller pen afterwards in a second, which you'll see, just to like get those finer details. So you can see me doing that now. These are so cute. I love the little like under the sea doodles and everything. But yeah, so those are the outlines of all of my spreads. And now we are adding color. So I used a little like light gray color of my Tombow Dual brush pens to color in the bottom of the calendar. And I mean, not calendar, the castle. And then for the pink part of the castle, which I'm currently doing now, I used a like the light pink pastel colored mild liner. And honestly, I wish I was able to find like a lighter pink that, you know, just was, I don't know, just a more subtle light pink. I feel like this was like super neon. I did try to adjust that when I put the spreads up on my Etsy shop so that it wasn't quite as in your face as it is in person. The camera is not really doing it justice. And then I added some light blue for like the rooftops of the Cinderella castle. And then the last color that I used was a yellow color just for the little like accents and little things of the rooftop and the castle and fun stuff like that. But despite the neon pink, I think that the colors are very pretty, very princessy and girly, and I just really like it. And then I colored in the little sparkly star things with a yellow Tombow Dual brush pen, and then I also outlined it with an orange. And then here I am adding all of the extra little glittery, sparkly, fun stuff in yellow and blue and pink, the same colors pretty much that I used on the castle. And I ended up like thickening the dots in a lot of places because I felt like it still looked kind of empty and blank. I originally just made the yellow ones like bigger and the blue and pink one smaller, but I fixed that later on. For the calendar, here you can see me doing the little shadow to the individual boxes of the days. So I used like all blues and everything, of course, because it was frozen, and I did it in this like ombre like light to dark pattern, and then I restarted it again once I like got through all the colors. So it just goes, you know, light to dark, and etc. You know, I really just love this look. I feel like it looked so empty before adding the color, but I think it's just so pretty and I really love it. And then, oh, here you can see like the little like circular little snowball snowflake things that I had added on. And then I also just took my little pens, markers, whatnot, and outlined the snowflakes in different colors. The reason why I didn't do the snowflakes just like straight in the colored and instead did like the black mild liner and then the colors on top of it was mostly because in the bullet journal spreads, like on my Etsy shop, I didn't want to have to make people like draw their own snowflakes or anything like that. So I just, you know, decided to do it for them and then add colors on top. For the habit tracker, the Princess and the Frog little lily pads and everything, I used different shades of green for all of the lily pads, and you know, I'll just color in the boxes of my habits with whatever color that I have for like the lily pad. And I also colored in the little fireflies, like, you know, the little yellow and blue and black, or it was actually like a dark gray and everything. I didn't color in the lily pads totally though, just so I could avoid like having streaky lines. And then there's not much to color on the mood tracker because that's a thing you do like throughout the month, so I just outlined the box in yellow for Belle. For the sleep and water tracker, I did the same thing with that little shadowed of the purple for Rapunzel and a teal color for the Little Mermaid. And then I also colored in the suns in this like dandelion yellow color. And for the silhouette of Flynn Rider and Rapunzel, I did like these purpley colors again to bring in some purples of Rapunzel. And another reason is just because the lanterns themselves, I chose to have like all yellowy colors for the lights, so I wanted to have that purple in there. I also added my moods and the hours of sleep and cups of water that I drank. Then I also added the colors themselves for my mood tracker. If I'm being honest, not too happy with the colors that I chose, but it's okay, we're just gonna go with it. I do like the colors, however, for the sleep tracker and the water tracker especially. I think the water tracker will turn out really cool. But so here's the finished final August spreads. I think it is so magical and beautiful. I hadn't like thickened up the little glittery polka dot stuff around it yet, but you can see that on my Etsy shop. And go follow my Instagram and TikTok for more updates. It's just carrie.walker. I love each and every one of you. I hope you all are having a wonderful day, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye guys!